And we're live. Y'all able to join?
Hold on, my connection timed out.
I don't know how to undo that. Oh, there it is. That's not right. Perfect. Everybody's ready. Ready to go. You guys ready?
Yep.
Whip, you ready to go?
You can't hear me, huh?
No, now I can.
I'm saying you left a lens cap on your stream again.
I haven't switched it over yet, but thank you. I would have forgotten. Fantastic. Hey, welcome back.
Okay, I'm ready.
All right, Tintasco, why don't you join the stream too? And while you're doing that, here we go.
Let's run it slow for a few moments.
Yeah.
So we can get familiar.
Why is this box still up?
Some of us are still loading.
Okay.
Yeah, it's still on mine, too.
And maybe you got to press play.
Maybe I got to hit start. There it is.
Yeah, that did it.
All right, so it's on
speed one. That's good.
Yeah. Where the hell are my troops? Oh, are troops still coming back from China? Yep.
And I have to say thank you for pulling me out of the bacon once again. Or my bacon.
It's all good. Again.
All good. It's all good.
Now you'll be the one pulling us out of the bacon, right?
Yeah, you will.
Yeah. Roger that. Hey, if I'm sending troops to you, do I have to do it? Do I just send them like, just kind of move them like on convoys, or do I have to like go into the interface and offer to send and all that good stuff?
Well, it depends how you enter the war. Like, let's say I invade Poland and France and England declare war on me, you guys are not automatically joined in that war. You can suggest to me to an offer to join the war, or I can ask you if you want to join the war. If you guys don't, then you have to send expeditionary forces, like with the Republic and Spain thing, you know?
Got it. Yeah, that makes sense.
If you guys join the war, then you can just run across Russia because you're in the same alliance. Just run across Russia all the way and do it that way.
Makes sense.
It So I'm doing the Danzig or War thing. It's about It's about 55 days away. 55 days. Soviet Union is justifying war goals against Poland, and they're done in March. February, March. So actually, Russia is going to be first. So I'm going to let Russia declare war on Poland, and we're going to see what happens. It's going to be interesting.
Right, so because he'll invite us, right? So we'll just decline it first.
I don't know. It might cause him to go into war with us as well. Who knows? I've never had that happen. Phineas still has a couple of divisions on a boat.
Working the way back.
My
It's a
divisions
slow boat
are
from China.
running across Russia. In February of all times. Can you imagine how bad of an idea that must be?
Isn't everybody pretty much over for attacking Russia in the winter?
Yeah, all our troops are there already. That would be such a bad idea right now.
These guys are like on a leisure tour of
You're also on speed one.
Sea of
You're also on speed
China.
one.
I know.
Yeah, I'm still trying to figure out my home situation here. I
Princeton
gotta
and
cover all
Steele.
my borders, except the one with Italy.
Oh, you never know. Just kidding.
Let me just draw a bunch of battle plans, okay? Because I might be going into Belgium,
Take your time.
France,
Take your time.
Poland at the same time.
I need to justify it. I'm going for Greece, guys.
Who's guaranteeing Greece right now? Anyone that we have to worry about?
Yeah. That would be Britain. I could go Bulgaria.
You probably want to pick someone who's not being guaranteed unless we're prepared to fight the guarantor.
Looks like Romania might be the choice then. Or Bulgaria, excuse me. Way to be Ali G, one of the mods in the house. Say hi to Tatasqua. Think you may know him. Tatasqua.
What's up, Ali G?
Hey. Ali, I'll turn the jukebox on for you. Hold on. There, now you can play music.
How do I create a new theater?
You, when you have your army highlighted, just hit new.
All right, guys, I'm going to start justifying Bulgaria. Who's got tungsten for me? Japan has tungsten. I'm only receiving 8 of it.
Good to see a way to be.
Nice. Fusion has been dropped off, LEG. Steel. I need steel. Might as well pick up from Germany. Yeah, he is, from what we hear. Later, Allie.
See ya, Allie G.
Oh. That's nice. Uh-oh. Sorry, guys. Bolivia... change of plans here. All of a sudden, Bulgaria is guaranteed by France and England.
I expected that. I expect Poland to be guaranteed by a bunch of nations as well.
So this is going to get real.
Oh, yeah. Poland is guaranteed by UK.
How do you tell that quickly?
Right click the nation. You want to see if they're guaranteed by anybody. And then there's a diplomacy tab. You'll see it there.
So when you roll into Poland, then Britain will declare on us. Is that correct?
If Russia goes for Poland, I want to get as much as I can from it. Yeah, I think what will happen, guys, is it'll be a full-blown total war here. Oh,
it's
man,
all right.
I got so much work left.
Take your time.
I'm right on the board of the British Raj and ready to go. Or is that Raj? And Phineas, I don't know if you know, if on the very bottom right-hand corner of the screen, if you check the little box here, you can see the battle plans that Whiplash is building.
Where is it?
Bottom right. That very, very far bottom right checkbox. Where you shut off the knight, the one to the right of it.
Oh, nice. Does it show it as distinct battle plans, or...? does it get confusing?
Here, not shows war. Right now I see the four and I see Russia's. Because they're with us too.
Check.
You see all allies.
Oh wow, look
check
at that.
The stream.
Poland is pretty fucked.
I do that.
Alright, so there's no way. Who's this? And you've got Austria already. There's no way for me to do this without causing hell.
Not make Russia angry. They still have tons of troops in China. Very slowly working their way out, but they're still here.
Well, there's Whiplash's 32 divisions coming back. Where the hell are mine?
Oh, that's interesting. He's got them on garrison, like the little shield. Hopefully,
who?
Russia is garrisoning one of my territories. Unless he's got them set and that's how he's pulling them back to Russia.
Okay, why aren't these guys heading back? Anybody know that? Why they're just sitting here?
Where?
It looks like they're here they go. They came into port.
He ran out of transport ships. They have to come over incrementally because you don't have enough. You see on the top you got like 142, 56, 33, yeah. Zero. Hover over the zero and it'll give you the rundown of what you're using for what.
207 contacts is tall. Probably want some transports, huh? Boy, I feel really exposed right now. Germany, what's going on? I see what you're doing there, Whip.
What am I doing?
You're loading up on my border with France.
Oh yeah.
I have 57 divisions there, just to let you know.
I'm going in there with you.
Alright. I have not made a battle plan there, and I have not justified against France.
You won't have to.
Yeah, he's going to declare on us when Whip goes into Poland.
All right. And so we just... Where are you going to push? Do you want me to push to the south, like Bordeaux? Like the bottom third of France?
I'm going for Vichy, yeah. Go for the bottom.
Okay. What do you mean, no divisions? Do you see where I'm going?
They're training.
Yours are? Mine are. Yeah, I'm gonna shut that off.
Just select your entire army and control click that, yeah, exactly.
Fifty-seven divisions of the Third Army. Tells me France is a little bit of trouble. Now, I'm leaving Italy completely exposed. Oh, that's yours, that's why. My guys aren't moving again. Oh yeah, now they are.
This is the month, guys.
Tally ho.
You're going into France?
Russia's gonna trigger it all.
That's not
and
good.
I don't know how that will turn out. You guys want to know how many fighters I've got deployed, ready to spring into action? 4,740.
Nice.
Holy crap. Yeah, not so much over here.
How do I, again, tell my people where to spawn? If you look at my stream, am I in the right screen to do that?
No, that's... you have to go to
this one.
No, you have to do it from the one with the armor up top.
Okay, 600 fighters northern France, 600 fighters southern France, 600 fighters western Germany, 600 fighters northern Germany, 600 fighters the Benelux area, 600 fighters the English Channel, and 400 fighters southern England. I think that covers it.
I think it's safe to say you have air cover.
Also, 400 Poland. We got this.
It's awesome.
All right. I want to get lots of naval bombers.
Make sure when the war breaks out, because it's going to be a long war, I think. Make sure You got enough factories, like full slots for your weapons. I have 2 full slots for my weapons. Like 2 full racks of factories. So if you guys start having shortages, call it out, eh? Because I might have enough surplus to give you guys a buffer.
It's good. Funny, the other thing is, once it gets going for a while, if anybody starts trying to do invasions on you, if you take like some troops and do like a fallback line right along the coast, then they'll just protect, you know, the coast for you as well.
Okay, so how do I get my naval bombers, Tintasqua, to do what you were saying?
How do you get what?
Them to fly around and defend my coast.
Oh, just assign them to the waters off the coast of the air zone that includes the waters off the coast of Italy, right there, okay. Tyrrhenian Sea.
Yeah, I just did that. All right.
Yeah, and you're good. I'm looking forward to watching Germany with everything all set up and ready to roll.
Yeah, we just gotta wait for good old Russia. Mine is gonna take a month longer, I think. 21st of March.
Okay, so are we ready to speed up, or?
I'm good to speed up.
I'd really like to know where my troops are. There they are. Bay of Bengal. So when war breaks out, I just hit that go thing and off it runs. Oh no, 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 that's not what I wanted.
Venezuela wants to join our faction. Should I accept?
Yes. Come on home, boys. There it is.
All right.
I think Hungary has troops in my area. Looks like they're going to go after Romania.
Sorry about that.
Yeah, you did that right at the wrong moment. I was trying to draw a line.
Okay.
right. I have 200 bombers, naval bombers.
Shit.
I now have strategic bombers. What do you need, Whip?
Poland's going away.
Whip, are you, did you go into France?
I don't think France is at war with us.
No, they're not.
When you hit the Soviet-Polish war, though, they show up on the participants.
Yeah, they are.
I'm not, yeah, and I'm taking their territory down here.
I don't know why I'm not advancing.
Venezuela's not giving me any oil. Alright, so what is that expeditionary request?
They want to send troops for you to use.
Okay.
Free troops.
Yeah, I'll take them. I need tungsten. Japan's not sending me any.
Sorry about that.
Mission.
Who? What? Who?
Poland didn't stand a chance.
Warsaw.
I'm gonna stop recruiting for a sec.
Oh, we're invading France, it looks like.
Wow, I lost a lot of planes already. 700.
I can't get any tungsten. Get it from Greece.
What's Whiplash, what's your thought on like medium versus heavy tanks?
I'm doing light only, actually. I can't afford to get medium tanks. But like Russia, I believe does medium tanks. Medium and heavy.
Yeah.
Yep.
Wow, I lost submarines, 7 destroyers. Oh no, they did. Wow, big war. Southern Italy and the Navy.
It's not easy in this out there because of the mountains.
At least
we got air superiority. I don't think we could run the game faster if we wanted to.
No.
I didn't expect Czechoslovakia to enter the war as well. Poland did not have any units on that front. I'm spread out thin there and the Russians are there to help, but I wish there was more I could do there to swallow that up. I want Poland to finish. Didn't they capitulate yet? Poland. No, 78%. Yeah. I probably need Danzig. Let me take that.
We're pushing into France, Whip. I'm gonna go bomb the crap out of southern France. My game's locked. There it is.
Belgium's gonna fall. I need to research paratroopers because I have no way of getting into England otherwise.
It's gonna be tough to get that air superiority built. Do you have to have air superiority to use them as well?
Yeah, but I have it though.
It's a good time then to get over there.
Why is my Alpine region in red? Am I losing that, or is that at war?
Where? Which one?
Look at my stream.
It might mean you don't have hover over it. It'll say it in red. It's an aviation thing.
Master tracks. How many French does it take to protect France? I don't know. Never been done before. What's going on, Hanson? Welcome to the stream, guys. Hey, Drone, what's going on? Drone asks, are we winning? I don't know. Whip? Tentasco, what do you think?
We're not doing bad at all.
I don't know if we're winning yet, Drone.
Phineas, if you click on the war emblem up top, it'll show you like a, it's got like sort a bar, 50-50. A slide bar right in the middle.
I don't even see me anywhere on that bar. Oh, maybe I gotta scroll down.
Come on, Poland, capitulate! I don't have time for this. Wow, all my fleets are murdered. Everything I had in the sea is murdered. Yep. The English.
Alright, my troops aren't coming home. Hey! Dirty Harry, man. Thank you for the follow. Really appreciate that. Can't get my troops back. Drone wants to know how the Nazi war machine is going.
Very good.
All right, guys. I can't seem to get my 23 troops home.
Where are they?
Africa.
At a port.
Yeah, and they won't go over the sea.
Because England took the Suez Canal.
Well, we're going to attack.
Doing good in the Alps there. Did some major redeployments, allies.
They got a lot of folks over there.
It's always Italy's fault. Always Italy's fault.
It's alright. I'm just waiting for you to switch sides once it starts going poorly.
You know, I got the t-shirt. I'm ready to go. Welcome to the stream. appreciate you checking us out tonight.
Running at a slow speed because we can't run it much faster. Three players at this point in the war. Let's see how it's going. So Poland capitulated, Belgium capitulated. We're holding them off at the Maginot Line. The Alps French border with Italy. It's not doing too great, but it's not doing too bad either, which is fine. We have air superiority over France, the Benelux area, Northern Germany, the English Channel, and the UK. Denmark is at war with us, but they seem to be not interested in going for much land. Russia is doing a good job as our ally, sort of populating all the front lines, making sure that the enemy can't advance where we have gaps. Switzerland is in the war even. They don't seem to be too interested in capturing much terrain. So what's going on right now is for France. I'm redeploying a bunch of troops to the north of France there to try and make a push for Paris. Sort of kick them in the gut while we're at it. USSR occupies eastern Poland.
Gentlemen,
I have two options to say to that.
Air Hansen.
The frontiers of communism.
Oh, yeah, I chose the one that says it won't last long. Air Hansen in chat says we in Denmark will take over again. The North, we will never forget.
Yeah, please do. Please go for Switzerland. I mean Sweden and Norway there. By all means, don't come after me. Oh, the Swiss are invading. I jinxed it. Now, what am I going to put there? I don't have anything to put there. I mean, the Danish are invading. Sorry. Let's see. Okay.
And they are holding onto the Nice area. I've got green, but there we go. Just gotta push one more group out. Drone, don't you dare. Sweden is strong and technically
Sweden drone is 75% SAP, Democratic Party. 14% not aligned, and 8% communist. They have literally no fascist party. 3% fascist.
We should start trying to get them to be more fascist.
Denmark, however, 47% fascist.
Yeah, Sweden's already in the Allies, but go after Finland.
Just ask what's happening over there with Japan.
We're working our way into the British Raj and heading down the peninsula.
Oh,
into
I see.
Siam. We're justifying against Siam.
Are you going to push all the way across into Iran and Iraq? Across the south?
Potentially, eventually. It depends on how soon we have to go fight Russia.
Oh, the sleeping bear. Don't poke the bear.
No, let's keep them as friends for now.
What's the U.S. doing?
Yeah.
They're all over my country. Oh, man, that would be such a bad idea right now to go against Russia at the same time. We pretty much have to win this entire war before we go after Russia. Four nukes.
Welcome to the stream, everybody. Right. If you scroll down, you'll see the commands down there for Jukebox and all the other stuff that we can do here in the stream. Thanks for checking us out. And I want to thank everybody because we are the number one channel right now that's playing Hearts of Iron. So thanks for hanging out with us and make us the top channel. That's pretty cool.
Okay, we have the Irish, the Danish, and the Swedish invading through Denmark. Just sent...
Yeah, I see your arrow up there.
I just sent my Panzer division, 24 Panzers I sent that way.
They got one guy right here. One division. Dirty Hair, there's two players here with me tonight. There's Whiplash, he's playing Germany, and Tentasqua is playing Japan.
Yeah, this voice is Whiplash, by the way.
And this is Tentasqua.
What happened yesterday, because we were playing yesterday as well, is one of the first moves I did as Germany was to justify war goals against the Netherlands and take them and fully annex them, so our rubber supplies are pretty safe. Then Italy went for Yugoslavia as expected. I annexed Austria as expected. I befriended Czechoslovakia. My intent was to have Hungary declare war on Romania, help them out, and then take the Romanian oil fields in the process. But Hungary did not end up declaring war on Romania. Then Tentasqua over in the Far East declared war on China, and they sort of did a switcheroo on him, started taking a lot of land and surrounded him pretty well. So Italy and Germany sent troops all the way to China to help that war to help win that war first. So that's what we did. It was like a 2.5 month journey over the sea to get our troops there, but it was an amazing battle. It was a lot of fun to play that.
And
so now he's working on British Raj right there.
And my troops weren't able to get home because obviously the United Kingdom now owns this, and I can't get them home. So I'm trying to battle my way up through Eastern Africa.
Australia is still intact.
Masturbator, what's going on, man? Where is it? There you are.
Australia actually seems to be running over my islands, my rubber islands. Damn Australians, they're everywhere.
They are down there, aren't they?
Bader, what are you doing?
You got a boat to spare? Oh, there seems to be some sort of invasion as well in Japan there in this.
I just noticed that.
Yeah, Dirty Harry, thanks for the point out here. I'm trying to get my troops home. I got naval bombers right here. 217 of them. That, matter of fact, I'll have them patrol there. So if they do try and come across, they'd be in trouble. But yeah, keep a eye on that Dirty Harry. Throw pasta at them. You wanted the pasta.
Let's see how the war is going. The war is going 3% in our favor, fellas. We're gonna do this.
Slowly. Where are you? Yeah. 3%.
British Raj is 3% towards capitulation. Actually, 9%.
Nishab Japan?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm pushing pretty good here from Italy into southern France. All green along the front. Through Nice. Gotta move down to Marseille.
Yeah, I started pushing back the Danish.
Yeah,
go
drone.
Back to your country, Danish.
Bite your tongue, drone. Bite your tongue.
Wars have been merged. Our allies are now the Soviet Union, Hungary, Japan, Manchukuo, Italy, Lictor, Ethiopia, Neo-Ottoman Empire, Venezuela, against United Kingdom, Poland, British Raj, United States, Philippines, France, Luxembourg, Switzerland, Canada, Czechoslovakia,
what are you
New Zealand,
doing?
Denmark.
Canada.
Well, Canada's like English still.
God save the
you
queen.
Know, they got ties, man.
And Dirty Harry, I'm also moving some divisions over here to protect.
If you zoom out and scroll over to Canada, you'll see that Newfoundland and
UK.
So Newfoundland and what is it?
Labrador.
Yeah. Wow, I should have known that. I'm a bad immigrant. Bad immigrant.
It's not like you don't live there or anything. Oh yeah, the Swiss border with Italy isn't going well.
Nope.
That's your defense,
there,
right?
But we're outnumbered. Yeah. I don't have enough troops for all these borders.
All right, I'm going to move a mountain division up there.
Wow, I have a lot of political power. I'm going to start doing coups. I'm going to do a coup in Denmark.
Why not?
With their 47%.
So can we invade Switzerland?
Yeah, we can. Just put troops on the border, make a plan, and go for it.
I don't have a ton of troops.
I'm going for Paris. I'm almost there.
Man, thank you. Call the arms.
So France is 33% towards capitulation.
Oh, nice push from the north, Whiplash. Yeah, you're driving right to Paris.
Yeah, I'm going to take Paris first, and then I'm going to swoop around and take that Maginot line from the back.
Nice. Yeah, if you take France, I'll go and rework my guys towards Switzerland and take care of that.
All right.
I'll pull my guys off the front.
Well, yeah, as long as we don't lose those Alps that we already took, it's all fine.
Yeah. Well, if you take all of France, though, right? If you take the capital, won't...
I don't think they'll capitulate. It's worth 50 victory points. There's a lot of other cities there. France is a good start. least I'm containing the Danish. Got me worried there for a second. Oh man, half my country is in ruins.
I think Switzerland is pushing in on us.
Yeah, they might be. I'm winning the wars in the north there of the border. It's very difficult because it's such mountainous terrain. It's very hard to fight in.
I'm pulling some troops back.
I don't have any mountaineers there, just SS. I was hoping that the SS would compensate for the Swiss issue. Let's see how this air war is going. Good. Air war is going good.
I'm building some troops and I'll go try to get some of your rubber land back in your islands.
Yeah, the Australians are, they're just walking across, you know?
Yeah.
Let's see, drone, if there's a Swedish flag along the French border. Yes, there's some Swedes. Armefordeling. Something like that. With like accents and two dots on the O.
Yeah, where are you? Vader, just casually walking up, going north.
How many of you guys in chat play Hearts of Iron 4? And if you do play Hearts of Iron 4, what nation do you usually play as? Meanwhile, oh shit, the Swedish are invading the coast of Germany. I have no troops to allocate there. I'll have to split my panzers in half.
Nice.
Hope that the other half can take care of the Danish. Come on, Russia, I need your help, man! I did kick the Danish back. So what I'm gonna do is, yeah, I'm gonna split my panzers in half and send them to deal with the Swedes that have come across the sea. Then what I should also do is take whatever remaining submarines I have and put them in the sea there so that they can't cross. Oh man, this is intense.
We're 10% to the good now, guys. 10%. Nice. Japan, what's going on over there? Nice. Where are you?
Hey, either one of you guys got extra infantry equipment? specific guns that are like maybe an old model kicking around you can send over?
Let me take a look.
I'm having trouble building troops to go get those islands for you, Whip, because I am many thousands of guns short before I can build anything.
Take a look as soon as I send these 20 submarines away.
Well, we're over the Alps, Whip. And I'm actually pushing into Switzerland now. Yeah, we're actually, Tintasco, why don't you talk a little bit about what we're planning to do here? A little bit of a series, everybody. We're thinking, well, Tintasco, why don't you talk about the 3-4 groups we're going to try and win this game with?
Well, Phineas and I are fairly new to the game, so it's our first actual playthrough is the Axis, like, in a group. And then we'll try the Common Turn and the Allies, and probably the next one after that, we'll just try to... By then, we should know what we're doing, so we get some smaller... Try out with some smaller non-traditional countries.
So, you know, we'll probably play every Friday night or so, whatever the schedule works out between the three of us with all of our real-life jobs. But be sure to keep checking us out. Hit that follow button, because three of us are going to be hanging out a little bit.
Yeah, me and Tintasqua are eagerly waiting for Italy Phineas to backstab us.
What? What?
Are those... Americans? Yep. United States controls Sardinia. That's great.
Guys, I'm going to give a save right here.
Not
so
sure.
if you lag a little bit. There we go.
All right, let me see what I can do about your weapons. How much do you need, ideally, to fix your situation instantly? How much do you need?
Like 40,000 rifles?
Or 20,000 stones, either one.
And 2,800 artillery if you get it kicking around, and 1,000 motorized, 4,000 support. And then I will be instantly fixed and on my way to take your islands back.
I can give you... How much artillery? How much do you need?
I am short 2,800.
I just
and
destroyed.
How much infantry equipment?
Oh boy.
Infantry equipment, 39.8K. Was pretty much full until I started making more troops to try to head out there.
There, it's on the way. My good Japanese friend.
You are the best. Let me go get your rubber trees back for you.
Japan, you're not sending me tungsten. Just got it from the guys.
So we almost have Paris. We'll have Paris in 34 days. Never mind. But we're going strong. We're going strong. I'm also starting to win the war in Czechoslovakia there. And after that's done, I can send those to Switzerland.
Thanks, Dirty Harry.
What happened before, when you guys start taking all the supplies for me, which is nice for the factories, all my convoys disappear. And I've been making a ton, too.
Look at Sardinia for a moment there, Phineas, that island. See any troop activity? I want to see where those 23 troops are at.
All right, so here's something, right? So
they're invading my island. Oh, yeah, here.
All right, I have 804 convoys, right? It says I need 8,000 for trade and supply. And I'm not importing that much. This is what happened before, right? When I lost all my convoys.
Yeah.
I wonder if that's Phineas and trying to pull all the supplies from me. And I'm trying to ship them to him.
Well.
That's weird. But I can't build 8,000, so Phineas, you might want to grab your supply someplace else. That's why I'm not delivering.
Alright, I'm pulling back off Switzerland's border. Whip.
Okay. Man, look at that. We're losing on all fronts there with Switzerland. I wouldn't pull back yet if you can. Oh, you need that for those troops there?
Yeah, I'm getting invaded. Yep, I got nothing protecting that front.
And where are you? The island itself, you mean, right?
Yeah. I'm just going to line them up near Rome.
But, okay. Can they go across there? Yeah, they can, if they have it. I'll probably send you... Here, I can send you... Okay, you pull off of Switzerland there, and I'll send 10 panzers there.
Okay. I mean, I got some pretty serious patrols that if they tried to cross, I'm not sure they would be successful.
Okay, the war is going 13% in our favor. France is 43% towards capitulation.
Come on.
I am now 0% towards capitulation. Before I was 10% towards capitulation.
You're not capitulating anything with.
Nope. Czechoslovakia is 44% towards capitulation. We're almost halfway there. British Raj is 13. That's sort of stayed the same, but now that Tantasqua has those weapons and artillery, he might be able to bring some change in that. Also, Australia, yeah.
Oh, Bader.
What's Bader say?
Just, it's the Australians.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
I don't even know if he's still here.
I feel pretty good about this battle map, though. If you zoom out and you see what's being attacked and lost and all that stuff, I feel pretty good about this. I can officially no longer take any research trees, any focus trees. Come on, Paris.
So, oh, okay, they're not there. There we go. Dirty Harry in chat is saying tried to influence fascism in UK or Sweden.
Yeah, I am boosting party popularity in Sweden. The UK, yeah, I could do that, but they have like, what is it called? They have like a natural buff against it. I still have air superiority over England and the English Channel, so I might just, you know, take him, but not yet.
In favor of the aggressors.
I now need 8,300 convoys. I don't get it. I'm not building that much.
Yeah, that's weird.
It's really weird, right? Like,
is drone still watching?
I'm short on everything. Like, I need 150 steel, 33 oil, you know, 25 aluminum. So I can't build because I have no convoys. Maybe I only have like 70 troops, 70 divisions.
Drone. Got bad news for you.
He's there.
Denmark 32% towards capitulation. Guess who's next after that?
Dun dun dun.
Norway. Just kidding. Bring it, bitch. Yeah, I will.
Yeah, no worries, Hanson. Thank you so much for that follow. Super appreciated. Glad you're enjoying the stream. Starting to push into Switzerland, Whip. Nice job up there.
Tough, man. France as well.
Yeah, look at you up there. A lot of 90s too on that front line.
Wonder what the Russians are doing.
Slow going in Italy. Good grief. I mean, in East Africa. Thanks, Hanson. I appreciate that. The sweet, sultry sounds of Phineas. News.
Nice. Oh, yes. I well needed done.
This. Well done.
Czechoslovakia has capitulated.
It just started, Drone. I think yesterday was our first real time together, Drone. Japan pushing west. CM.
Paris has fallen. This is not an easy game, man.
I feel like you're alone. It's like it's so in depth, right? There's more you can do if you really learn it, you know, for the strategy and the game controls.
Oh yeah.
I always forget those industrials and the research that goes down those tabs to the right in the red. They call your factory research and stuff. I always forget that stuff.
Yeah, fake them. They're my highest priority.
Denmark has capitulated, Drone. Nah, Drone, didn't miss anything there. It started out as just teaching me what to do. Tintasqua, like, YouTube the crap out of it. Knows a ton. Whip obviously knows a ton. Yeah, so I think yesterday was our first time. I think I'd played this game 3 times as of yesterday. Don't touch my precious Sweden, he says, Whiplash.
Well, Should I establish Vichy France? Yeah, eh? I think I'm gonna do that.
Yep. Are we crashing?
Was it too much at once?
Oh, nope, there it is.
There we go. Vichy France has declared war on France.
That can't be good for France.
Nope. Now, all those troops you have in the Vichy France border there, Phineas?
Yes.
Put them on Switzerland.
Okay, so pull them out.
Yeah.
Okay. Good grief. Drone invade Spain. Fall of Hong Kong. Nice job. Yeah, we're not gonna do anything with that war goal. Where the hell are my troops trying to go?
Phineas, I want you to zoom in on Sweden for drone.
Okay. Uh-oh. Ooh, whip. That's fast. Drone, we're playing at the slowest rate, and look how fast he's just walking through.
Blitzkrieg, baby!
He's not even stopping to have meatballs.
There's panzers as well. I heard there's a really good IKEA in Norrköping or something like that. So I'm like, full speed ahead.
Enemy has air superiority. Hold on, I gotta pull back.
Oh, yes.
You stay away. It's just south of Nunkoping, if that's how you say it, drone. Nor.
Actually have a pretty decent deficit of support equipment in my production. Good thing I had such a surplus. fix that.
I'm getting short of everything, but it's because I have no convoys, right? So I can't pull in what I need. And I'm still fighting, so I'm still using up everything. It's weird.
What do you need most of?
I'm short 17,000 rifles. And then support equipment, and then artillery. So I just can't build anything right now.
I can't send you too much infantry equipment because...
Using it too. You're using it too, right?
Yeah.
I lost in these guys are all combined now. Well, I welcome you, Nazi bastards.
To do Switzerland first, then I can redeploy some troops towards Sweden. Sweden's not going too well, actually, you know.
Good lord, you took all of France. Oh, drone. Bader, there you go, drone, embrace it. You guys are funny. How we doing, Japan?
I am building some infrastructure back to port, seeing if that helps, like the supplies.
I'm going to strategically bomb Zurich.
Good idea. Low manpower. Like 900k people. I'm gonna ignore that for a little while. I need things to like settle down a little bit. Once we have Switzerland and we dealt with these remnant French and these Swedes, I'm just gonna bunker down.
Yeah, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna close my economy and see if that doesn't stop everybody taking my convoys and let me get my supply situation back in line. I usually play with the closed economy, and I think that's what's different, right? Because I'm still on limited exports, so they're getting pulled out.
Yeah. I'll give it a go. How many convoys you have?
I have 823.
Total. Wow.
And it says I need 7,952.
I do have a YouTube channel, Hansen, but it is just replays of, you know, my Twitch broadcast. But you can go search Typical Phineas on YouTube and find me there.
Is it me, or did the United States just take one of these islands? I mean, the United Kingdom. One of these rubber islands.
Hey, thanks, Hansen. I just don't want to do all the editing and stuff, so I just dumped this. I prefer Twitch.
No, they always had the United Kingdom always had that right there.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah, the guys that should make a guide for this game are Tintasqua and Whiplash for sure.
I don't know about that yet.
Great news, Luxembourg.
It lasted a really long time, those guys, with their one platoon.
It's a hell of a platoon. Are you attacking Switzerland as well?
Yeah, but it's sort of a weird border.
Yeah, it's all like all over the place.
If you look at... like, I can't even figure out which armies I have there.
Right, me neither. That's why I was like, are you attacking it too?
You know what? I'll split this up.
I get 68 divisions going for it. That's probably a little much. God, I got divisions out in Paris now. What the hell are you guys doing up there? They're surrounding Switzerland. That's what my guys are doing. You know what, guys? I'm gonna save.
Sure.
Okay.
There's a ton of bombers coming across the English Channel. Okay, I'm gonna reallocate a bunch of these fighters.
Yeah, if you want to pull stuff off Switzerland, I got a massive amount. Whip.
Okay.
Guys in Africa are not doing anything down there.
Dude, it's June 1940. We're doing great. If you think about the fact that we went all the way to China and back, and, you know.
Yeah, we did.
Little detour, but all good.
We could have a piece of Bulgaria too if we want. Get some of that Russian oil. Do I have anything I can send there? I do. Got a bunch of Hungarians.
I got U.S. and Sardinia.
You know what I'll do? I'll send a bunch of Vichy France there.
Switzerland.
Finally.
Bye-bye. All right, I'm pulling back all my troops. And I'm going for Sofia, like I was going to before. And that last bit, a little bit of France is almost dead. No drone. We have not had any American visitors yet.
They're volunteers.
But you can see we've kind of got them trying, right? But I got a pretty good Navy hanging around. I think it's gonna get interesting in Italy here soon.
All right, let's see. The war is going 32% in our favor.
Nice.
Soviet Union has lost 114,000 troops. I lost 243,000 troops as Germany. Japan lost 112,000 troops. Italy lost 88,000 troops. Pretty good, Phineas.
I don't know about that. I don't feel like I've been engaged in very much.
Vichy France lost 184 guys.
Severe losses. Way to be committed.
Right? That's Canada lost 56,000 troops. Come on, Vichy France.
My guys are slugging it out down in Africa.
Right, I totally forgot about Africa. That's where I can send these panzers.
Hansen, no one cares about Canada.
Yeah, they're a tough country to play. I'm gonna push for Stockholm while it's still July.
Wow. Vichy France has a lot of ships. Well, 13 ships. It's not a lot. A little more.
I'm not in Stockholm yet. Zoom in on Sweden there, Phineas. Let's see if we got drones land already.
Copenhagen, Stockholm, not quite. Oslo. No, he's not quite in Stockholm. Yep. Hey, Destroyer, thank you so much for the follow. Really appreciate that.
Drone, are you ready for Battlefield 1 next week? You better be ready, boy.
Hometown. He's asking if it's the beta.
Yeah, it's the open beta. Hey, Bader, you're not doing too bad there in the Asian islands. Sort of just strolling along.
There is a sub button. You can sub if you'd like.
Romania, I bet Romania is going to capitulate in less than a day.
stupid idiot farmers. There is a monthly sub button. If that's what you were talking about, Hanson. Or if you're talking about follows, yeah, I appreciate everybody hitting the follow button too. We gotta be pushing 200 followers soon. Hold on, let me, sorry for looking at the blue water here, guys. I gotta open another screen. Yes, I think there's a sub button. Let me look at my channel. I mean, I appreciate you looking to, I mean, subbing is donating money. That's the sub. The follow button is the one that. Channel. You know what? I don't think I put the sub button there. If you are looking to donate, you can always just do a tip. I do not have the sub button up.
You gotta repeat that, Phineas, because sometimes your voice doesn't capture it.
All right, my sub button is not up, so subbing on Twitch means you're gonna pay a monthly subscription to us. The follow button is like the sub on YouTube, and since I don't have that set up, if you are looking to do something to give money towards the channel so that we can continue to work on our equipment and stuff, be my guest and use the tip bar. Never expected, always appreciated. Romania.
Let's see how my research is going. Paratroopers, 141 days left. Try and see if you can speed it up to speed 2, Phineas.
Yep.
Increase it by like 100%. Yeah, it works. Nice.
Yeah, I appreciate that. Really do, Hanson. I don't have my my monthly sub button up, but I do have a tip jar.
I live to play. Yeah, Hearts of Iron 4 is a grand strategy game. Paradox Games made a few of these. This is the fourth edition. They also have other games that are grand strategy games, like Europa Universalis, Crusader Kings. I wouldn't necessarily count Stellaris in that group,
no,
but yeah, they have Stellaris as well.
Yeah, they actually make City Skylines. I think you said that, Whip.
Yeah, that's true. You said that before earlier, yep. Yesterday.
Another, that's a game I play a lot on this stream, on the channel, everybody.
And this specific game, Hearts of Iron 4, it's, you know, it's not an RTS where you say this unit attack this region, this unit attack that region. It's really about the macro management of World War II. So economics, production, supply lines, grand strategies. So like, okay, this is the front line. All these troops try and take this region, etc. So the voice you're listening to now is called Whiplash. I play as Germany. Phineas plays as Italy, and Tantasqua plays as Japan. We're an alliance of three real players, and we also have the Soviet Union in our alliance. And you're seeing the war in 1940. What happened yesterday when we were playing was the usual route where Italy takes Yugoslavia, Germany takes annexes Austria and takes... Actually, I didn't follow the usual route for Germany. I actually invaded... Oh, there we go.
Yeah.
I invaded the Netherlands first. I annexed them. And then I tried to befriend Czech Republic. Didn't really work out 100%. And in 1939, Italy and Germany went to go help out in the East in the Chinese-Japanese War. We won that war. And then because Russia invaded Poland... that dragged us all into the war with the Allies. So that's sort of what you're seeing now is us doing a good job in reaching 1940, sort of the way it's supposed to, where England is still intact, France has been conquered, and yeah, I think the way the map looks right now, it's pretty historical, except for Republican Spain, of course. We'll do something about that later.
Except for that. Oh my, look at United Kingdom's got a lot of troops in East Africa right now.
East Africa. Oh wow.
Right, my poor 24. But they're holding their own.
No worries. I'm sending 17. Actually, no. I'm sending 24 SS divisions over to Africa.
Oh, you want to see Sweden? He's rolling over Sweden pretty good.
I've actually halted the process.
He took Stockholm.
Yeah.
Live to Play, thank you so much for the host. Really appreciate that. Thank you again. It's a great way to spread the channel.
Are we taking Bulgaria?
Trying to.
Let's do something about that too.
Anson! Alright, game speed lowered to have Tintasqua catch up.
Sweden. Neutral Sweden drone. Sweden invaded me first, sir.
Tintasco, what's going on over there in Japan?
Finishing it up the peninsula with Siam, and I'm going to send those troops down to start working on Australia. And our other group is working on the British Raj. We're in some fairly severe supply challenges. We don't have enough convoys, which means we can't get enough steel and other things to build the same convoys that we need. I closed my economy, trying to keep more of the resources in-house and not let them be exported, and we're hoping that's going to help.
Well, good luck in British Raj. My guys in Italy are trying to hold their own. In East Africa. Yeah, Live to Play. He took it. Japan took China. Overran it. Hungary and the Soviet Union are also moving in on Bulgaria.
Yeah, those Hungarian troops I can control.
All right, very good. Yeah, World War II. Live to Play. World War II. Sorry about that. Look at Italy. I've pushed all the way coast to coast here. Next will be Greece.
Remember, when you transport troops with naval, you have to actually right-click the actual anchor, or it doesn't work.
Okay.
Not just the land that they're in, the whole legit anchor.
Drone, not gonna happen, bud. Not gonna happen. After Bulgaria. Is Mirica in this game? I don't know.
America? Yeah, of course.
America, yeah. I was like, America? What? What? Yes, over America. Here. We have not poked that bear yet.
Nope. They're just greasing their wheels.
A little early for them.
I thought about, you know what? Let me, like, make Mexico fascist so that they can attack the states from the south, but that's so pointless.
Germany tried to get them to do that in the actual war. And the states actually intercepted the telegram.
Nice. Little history lesson there for everybody. Yeah, Liv, I'll do that after I'm done with Bulgaria.
Oh, what happened?
Where?
It's frozen.
Not for me.
No, it's not. There's Belgian troops in Brazil. Gunter, the blonde knight of Germany, Stutz shot down Thunder. Our latest mission over the English Channel was a great success for the German Air Force in more than one aspect. Reports have come in highlighting Gunter, the blonde knight of Germany, Stutz's heroic deed, managing to outwit the British pilot Percy Roberts, known as Thunder. The blonde knight of Germany used himself as bait and lured Thunder into a trap where the German pilots were able to dive on Thunder's squadron. The blonde knight of Germany proceeded to outmaneuver the British aircraft and with a single burst sent Thunder spiraling from the skies of the English Channel. Good job, dude. You get a raise. We're not at war with the United States, though, are we?
I don't think so.
And they're in the Allies. They're in the war. Yeah, I'm at war. The United States is at war with us.
Well, it's getting far away.
He can't take Tibet because they are neutral. He's only taking India, which was part of England at that time.
I could justify against them, but I'm having so many supply challenges. I don't want to spread out any, create any more troops. I'd rather go take the British Raj. And if I get some convoys, I'm going to try to head over and take that little piece of the United Kingdom on the island down there to the south, southeast.
Hey, Tintasco, how do I set up my navies to patrol again? I forget.
You go into your navy, and then up at the top, right above where you named it, you'll see the different. All right, hit patrol, and then you right click three adjacent sea lanes.
Or two if you don't want to spread too thin.
Yeah, but they. There we go. Got it. Yeah, I got the U.S. fighting me, naval battle.
In between Sicily and
Naples, between Greece and Italy.
Start churning out a bunch of naval bombers.
I think I won.
Stick them. I'd get a bunch.
I have a ton of naval bombers, yep.
All my deficits are gone, man. It's awesome.
I have 259 Tintasqua.
I can't build anything.
Hansen, yeah, that's early. I typically do, weekends. In my afternoon, I'm in Eastern Time, United States. Usually a night or two on the weekends, about 8 o'clock Eastern Time, PM. Ooh, guys, that's early. The hell you, or late. That's right, Hansen. I appreciate anything. 418 drone. Goodness. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to take these naval bombers and move them over there.
Try bump it up another speed notch, see if it goes, Phineas.
Yep.
You're gonna lose Italy, eh? I mean, Africa?
Yeah. I mean, look at the amount of troops I've pulled down there, though. I can't believe Bulgaria is hanging on like they are.
Bulgaria is pretty strong, it seems. Well, you know, they know the lay of the land.
There we go. Now we're pushing.
Where are you pushing?
I just pushed eastwards into Bulgaria.
Africa is a tough battle, all that attrition. I would really freak England out if I was able to just pop across that English Channel. But no, not yet. Ooh.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I'm pushing at England and in Egypt. Sort of squeeze them from the back.
Yeah, I don't even know where my troops are down here right now. Yeah, they're still in that little quadrant. Oh, I see what you're doing, Whip. Well played.
Sweden's still going strong.
This island is concerning me.
Which island? The one with the three troops on it?
The one below France's island in the Mediterranean.
Okay. I'm gonna send troops there.
Yeah.
See how the war is going. 32% in our favor. British Raj is 41% towards capitulation. Sweden is 83% towards capitulation. Bulgaria 78%.
Yeah, it's
actually not doing too well.
Where?
In Sweden. It's because winter's hitting.
damn ass cold.
Yep.
Got research to do.
See if we can bump it up one more speed.
Now we're getting some resistance to occupation.
Yeah. Desert rat.
Hey, Bulgaria is mine. Expeditionary Force.
How are you hanging in there, Tasqua?
Still going because of the low supplies.
Right.
It's kind of like Africa, right? You just kind of slog along. Mm-hmm. Still says I need 6,000 convoys. Which...
Ethiopia has capitulated. United Kingdom's falling in behind me as I'm trying to race north.
So you have zero convoys free?
Correct. I mean, it thinks I need 6,000, which doesn't seem right, right? Like, I wonder if I just stop trading all across, right, and cancel everything with anybody, like, from the folks. No, the only thing it says I'm trading right now, the only thing I'm importing is steel. Everything else I stopped.
So weird.
Going after Greece.
Where are you deploying your troops? In old China?
Yeah, I'm down by the old Netherlands, right? By the Philippines. Mm-hmm. And then I'm in the British Raj, and that's it. And it's not like I have crazy amounts of troops either.
Okay, we took Malta.
Oh, sandstorm in East Africa, check it out. Look on the stream.
Oh wow, that's cool.
Right. I'm finally breaking out in the Raj.
Oh yeah, you are. All right, we're still getting some resistance. Oh, that's my resistance.
Yeah, you have to build MPs at some point, but it depends on if you still need combat, you know, enough combat guys.
Good idea. Thank you.
garrison in those areas and it'll suppress it. Usually, like the horse cavalry guys are good for that, right? Not expensive, they can get around well.
Going after Greece.
I'm going for French Guinea and where Brazil is.
Oh boy. Oh boy. Merge to wars.
That's all right.
Looks like we took that island back, so that was good news. Marco, nice job to start World War II. Way to go. Thank you. All right, so how do I build MPs?
There's something you attach to another unit. So what I usually try and do, I didn't do it this time around, is I build I make a separate unit with cavalry because they have natural repression against, you know, revolts and all that stuff. And then I also add MPs to that to give them that extra boost.
Okay. So I need to, what, create a new army?
You have to train some first, yeah. Train a new group.
They're back.
Sandstorm is just not going away, is it?
Oh no. Look at that.
Nice.
Nice. All of Singapore.
Actually, wait a minute. Oh yeah, nice.
Yeah, we're getting there. The British they had a lot of folks down here. They were dug in. It took a little bit longer than I hoped, but we're getting there.
Now look, Italy is connected there.
Yeah. Should I change my front line now? I was trying to go north.
Well, France is taking Italy from the... If you focus on like the south and the west, I'll take the north.
Okay. So I'm deleting that line on the United Kingdom.
On that side, yeah. I want to switch my economy to like all the better stuff, but I don't have the cojones for it.
was on the second, this group that just took, they gotta come out here. I'm gonna make some of these guys into my MPs and convert them. And that way I'll free up some of the support equipment and artillery for the other guys that are short. The challenge right now is I can't even take convoys to get over those islands.
Right.
Started researching Nuke.
Really?
Well, the beginning phases of it.
Oh, okay. I was like, wow. 1940, Phineas is going to have a nuke?
Why not? 447 days away. I still don't know how to do this MP thing.
Okay. Like, do the make new unit thing to make a new template and then add four squads of horsemen, like cavalry.
I don't have them.
And then on the side.
So do a train.
No. Like, edit the template. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. But I don't think I'm making any. I'm not making any cavalry right now.
No, that's fine. So edit the template first and add MP to that on under support on the side. Man, Sweden stuff. It's not any actual Swedes there fighting, though. Just Americans.
All right, so check the stream whip. So do mount, do...
Oh, wow, those are big squadrons. They're huge. That's a tank division, though, eh? You're editing?
Yeah, hold on. So
don't edit that one. It's canceled back out of that. And on the top on division designer. I would edit just your existing cavalry. Your regrupamento celere there.
And make them MPs.
No, you're editing an existing thing. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, and add under support, add MPs. Exactly.
I wish you could garrison them while the.
What's that, Whip?
Save it on the bottom. Save. 10 star. You don't have to add more horses because you'll need more infantry for that. You know.
All right.
Valuable
too late.
Resource. What's that task?
I was gonna say, I wish when you put up the resistance heat map, I wish you could click the garrisoning of the different regions at the same time instead of the way you have to leave it and try to remember where all the hotspots were.
Right.
All right, so now where are those at low manpower? Where are those units, those cavalry MP units now going, Whiplash?
You probably didn't select the land yet where you want to deploy them.
Okay, so where do I do that?
Under recruit and deploy on the top, which is the tank with the arrow that points down, scroll to where you're training your cavalry and then make sure they have a location there set.
Okay. I sent him up north. Oh, nope, I don't want to do that.
I closed the economy's working now. I'm down to needing 3,000 convoys, and I have 1,000.
Are you in need of something?
I am in desperate need of. Well, I cut everything back. So
tell me your numbers, what you need.
Oh, of supplies. Actually, I got my the supplies are finally getting fixed. It's weird, but let me check here. I just canceled my Marines, and I'm converting some other troops to that. So I just canceled a bunch of stuff I was building. I need 200 towed artillery, 2,000 motorized, and 3,200 support. And any planes? I have like zero planes. As I get some convoys, I'm going to go start taking some of those islands back for you.
You don't need any infantry equipment?
No, I'm 10,000 to the good on that one because I'm swapping out, I'm upgrading that. So that one's fine.
32% to our favor. Good night, drone.
Good night, drone.
How you doing in East Africa? What, you taking that United Kingdom area?
200 artillery, right? I'm gonna give you 1,000.
Nice.
And how much support equipment?
3,000. Look at that. Everything's turning green. This is beautiful. Thank you.
Welcome. Got a ton of attrition in Africa. That's crazy. But your troops aren't fixing the Libyan desert, Phineas.
Where do you want them to go?
The Libyan desert, the west, because France is encroaching on Italy there.
Yeah, I haven't done anything. I got no troops there. Want me to draw a line the whole way?
Yeah, please. I'm just sending some troops there as well. Okay, I'm finally gonna research these submarines. It's only gonna take me 36 days.
It's awesome. You have all the discounts going.
Losing quite a significant amount of people. Where though? Where are these people dying?
You looks like people are trying to cross the English Channel.
No, that's a, oh, my guys? No, that's no, fine.
The British.
Yeah, they've been trying to do that for a while now.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got that covered.
Thank you so much for the follow. Undead. Undead Devil, thank you so much. Appreciate that.
I think it's Greece where all my guys are dying.
You can use your credits for song requests. Live to play. Scroll down, you'll see the command for it. Yeah, this is a bloody battle.
Greeks are trying to take Turkey as well. Who would have thought? Something's gotta give. I'm losing a ton of people somewhere and I have no idea where.
That's tough. I gotta learn more about supplies. That's what's that's the key point I'm learning on this game, that I gotta dig into that hard.
Yeah, I'm losing against Greece right now.
You know, the first person to run out of people to send at the machine guns, those are the people that lose.
True.
Sending my strategic bombers into Greece. I'd prefer not copyrighted Live to Play, because I do want to publish this. So if you're going to do that, make sure it's NCS, please. Because this has been a great gameplay and I do want it to go up on YouTube. I don't want to get a strike over there. So please, only NCS if you're going to do that. Thanks, man. I appreciate that. Yeah, we're still losing.
Building oil refineries to try to get out from under having to trade for that.
Yep.
I think my mistake was not going to close. Usually, like early in a game, I go to closed economy once war starts. I think that was my mistake.
Thank you. What?
What?
Your game is no longer in sync.
We gotta save. We gotta keep it paused. We gotta save and you too, Phineas. Press pause and save it. Because my game's paused right now.
It's weird. Was it saying it needs a different version or?
You gotta save it and then you gotta restart.
Alright, I just saved it.
Yeah, we have to restart the game though.
Okay. It is 11 o'clock. Do we want to keep going or call it here for the night?
I'm good to call it. Maybe we can review what our problems are real quick.
Sure.
Yeah, I'll go. Mine has been supplies. I don't know if I built too much inventory. I don't think so, though, because I don't have that much. I've never seen the need for 3,000 convoys before like that, so I'm going to have to do some research on that and see if going to a closed economy earlier would help.
Might be a simple problem. You know, might be something super weird.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. I'm sure someone else has run into it, so once I Google it, I'll see what I can learn, and I'll share it with you guys next time.
Yeah, we're going to have to deal with Greece for me next time.
They're putting up quite a fight, aren't they?
Yeah, they really are.
My problems are the fact that my entire plane industry has just... I just realized that I'm not manufacturing any plane whatsoever because all those factories have been sabotaged. So I have to figure out some sort of scheme where I think I'm going to stop building troops and just focus on...
planes now?
Well, yeah, trying to deal with this resistance.
You need some MPs. Like, if you have, like... If you're switching to mostly armor, right, towards the end of the game, maybe switching some of your infantry over to MPs.
All right. Well, everybody, I want to thank you very much for hanging out with us tonight. Thank you for all the awesome follows. It was fantastic. And come back and see us. We're going to be playing this probably once a week. Thank you for the loyal viewers that keep coming and coming and coming to view us over again. Thank you for all the new followers. Big thank you to Tintasqua and Whiplash for hanging out with me tonight. Hit that follow button. It really does help me out. And we'll see ya when I see ya.